Dear children, in the previous class, we have studied that the electromagnetic radiations have the wave character. But later on, there were many observations which were not explained by the wave nature of the electromagnetic radiations. These observations were like black body radiation, the photoelectric effect, and the line spectra of the atoms, especially hydrogen. Today we will study about the wave and the particle nature of the electromagnetic radiations and the dual behavior of matter also. Particle nature of the electromagnetic radiation and the Planck's quantum theory. Planck explained the black body radiation. The ideal body which emits and absorbs all type of radiations is known as a black body. And the radiations which are emitted by the black body are known as the black body radiations. Max Planck suggested that atoms and molecules absorb or emit the light in discrete unit, not in the continuous manner. And that smallest packet of energy was named by Planck as quantum. It was observed that when a solid substance is heated, radiations are emitted. For example, if we heat an iron piece, the radiations are emitted. The color of the radiation changes as the temperature changes. Initially, when the temperature is low, the color of the radiation is dull red. But as the temperature increases, the color changes from dull red to bright red and then white and then blue. As the temperature increases, the frequency increases. Frequency and temperature are directly related. The red color falls in the lower frequency region and the blue color falls in the higher frequency region. The energy of the quantum will be given by the relation E is equals to h nu. Capital E is the energy of the packet, that is the quantum. H is the Planck's constant. And nu is frequency. Photoelectric effect. Just see the picture. Here you can see the light in the form of a wave striking or hitting a clean metal surface which is placed in an evacuated tube. As soon as this light strikes the surface of the metal, an electron is ejected. This is known as photoelectric effect. So we can say that there are some metals like potassium, rubidium, cesium on which when a light strikes, an electrons are ejected. These electrons are known as photoelectrons. It was also observed that there was no time lag between the striking of the light on the metal surface and the ejection of the electron. Also, it was observed the number of electrons ejected is directly proportional to the intensity or the brightness of the light. More is the brightness of the light, more is the intensity of the light, more is the number of electrons ejected. Threshold frequency, that is nu naught. Dear children, every metal has its own minimum frequency. And a light with that minimum frequency must strike the metal surface to eject the electron. If a light with less than threshold frequency strikes a particular metal, it will not eject electrons. Now the scientists were in dilemma that electromagnetic radiations have what type of nature? Because some of the properties like interference and diffractions were explained by the wave nature. And the photoelectric effect or the black body radiation, they were explained by the particle nature. This confusion, this dilemma was resolved when the scientists decided to accept that the electromagnetic radiations have the dual behavior. That is, they have the wave nature and the particle nature, the dual behavior of matter. Just on the lines of the dual behavior of the electromagnetic radiations, de Broglie also suggested that matter has also dual behavior. But this dual behavior was observed in the electrons and the subatomic particles and not in their heavier objects. Mathematically, de Broglie's equation is lambda is equals to h upon p. Here lambda is the wavelength, h is the Planck's constant and p is momentum. And momentum is equals to mass into velocity, so we can also write as lambda is equals to h upon mv. From this relation, it's very much clear that wavelength is inversely proportional to mass. If the mass is higher, then wavelength will be small. So we will not able to observe the wave character of a heavier particle. It's only observed for the very small, very light particles of the range of the mass of electron and the subatomic particle. And on this behavior only, the electron microscope is based. Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Heisenberg observed and suggested that it is impossible to find simultaneously the position and momentum or velocity of a subatomic particles. You have to keep in mind the two things while defining Heisenberg uncertainty principle. He says simultaneously it is impossible to find the position and velocity of a subatomic particle with certainty. Separately we can find out both the things. Position we can find out accurately and momentum also we can find out accurately for a subatomic particle. But if we'll try to find out these two things, the position and the velocity simultaneously, we cannot find it out. Any instrument or any technique we apply, if we want to measure the accurate velocity, then the position will be changed. And if we'll find out the position, the velocity will be changed. Mathematically, Heisenberg uncertainty principle is delta x into delta p greater than equals to h upon 4 pi. Or you can say delta x into m delta v greater than h upon 4 pi. Delta x, it is uncertainty in position. Delta p is uncertainty in momentum. And since momentum is the product of the mass and velocity, we can also write p as m delta v. Why m delta v? Because m is a constant quantity, so we are not putting delta before m. Delta v is the change or the uncertainty in the velocity. H is Planck's constant. For the numerical purposes, we remove this sign greater than equals to and instead of it, we put equals to. The common mistake here is the children, they write 2 pi instead of 4 pi. So just now we have studied the dual behavior of electromagnetic radiations and the matter. The electromagnetic radiations have the wave nature and the particle nature. There are few properties which are explained taking the wave nature, and there are some phenomena which are explained by the particle nature. The photoelectric effect, that why some metals eject electrons when a light of a suitable frequency hit their surface. Potassium, rubidium and cesium are common examples because their ionization enthalpies are low. The light has sufficient energy to eject electron. And these electrons, when ejected, we can say that current is flowing. Because the motion or the movement of the electrons, there is the current in the opposite direction. We also studied the de Broglie's dual nature of matter. An electron microscope is also based on this observation. Heisenberg's uncertainty principle says that we cannot find out exact position and exact velocity of subatomic particles simultaneously. I hope this is all clear to you.